Today we will talk about Rocket theory and Rocket numbers. And the beginning of the theory starts from the one question, which was put it first into some Hungarian mass media, and then it was presented as some American, I think, didn't know the name of it. So, suppose we have a group of 6 persons. We can prove that we can prove that there are at least three persons mutually friendly. Or at least three persons which are poor, I don't know, probably, which are mutually strangers. Mutual strangers. So, of course, we can write illustration in graph. So, we have a graph with 6 vertices, vertices of people, and then we can. So, there are 2 different. We can give 2 different situations. Either we can connect 2 people where there are mutually friends and not connected with mutually strangers, or we can just follow all edges in incomplete graph of these vertices into 2 colors, for example, red and blue, where, for example, red is where mutually friends, and other and blue is mutually strangers. So the picture is going to be arbitrary graph. We have complete graph of 6 vertices, and then we color all edges into the 2 colors, red and blue. And we wonder if there are a red triangle. So for which such coloring, we always have red triangle or okay, so you can, if you have any ideas, we can discuss it. Yeah, so yeah, there's, I think it's rather so, for example, in this picture we can have, in this picture we have red triangle and blue triangles, red triangles here. And blue triangle. But so we can have both, but at least one red or at least one blue we always have. We will always have. And so on. We can just think of it how to prove it. Sixth is minimal number such that the statement is true. So can we change? So for example, so can we change this to five? So can we prove the same statement for the five persons? Or can we have a counterexample? Can we have an example of graph which edges a color into red and blue such that there are no triangles? Can we draw? So remember, we can have red one go outside and blue all that inside. Yeah. So we can easily put the red and the blue up to the cycle length 5, so there are no triangles. Okay, so 6 is minimum. So this arises to question in for arbitrary numbers, and this is called the Ramsey number. So Ramsey number R of K is minimal number that the so I will just roll the generalization of this problem where I have arbitrary K and L instead of 3 here. And so I just give you two different definitions using the two coverings or just graphing its complement. So into two coverings it will be can we convolute each other such that for each two coloring of edges in complete graph K big N, we have or blue A. So we have click with the elements of red. Which is without edges, alright? Or we have adverbs such that all edges with them are blue. So let's keep it just that we can reformulate this as complete graph of adverbs where all edges is red edges. All edges, alright? Or we can have it the edge subgraph. All edges of the and also we can we'll not try it, but we can just think about coloring and say so we can say that there is a minimal number such that for each graph of vertices either we have key click or a anti click. So either we have key vertices where we have all edges over here, we have no edge. And our task, so our question here is stated that A3 is 3, or R3 is 3, runs the number of 3 and 3, is equal to 6. We just prove it. So we prove that if we have 6 vertices, then for each two colors we have and if we have 5 vertices, that means we don't have it. Of course, if this condition is holding for n, then it is holding for all numbers greater than n. So and here, if we can just restrict our graph on the only number of vertices, and so it's called for n, then called for each for vector. And of course, if we have some example for n minus 1, of course, we can have some example for all less than n, because we can just take a subgraph of this graph. So if this graph is not triangle, then each subgraph less number of vertices, we're also doing this contrast graph. So here we have, if you want to prove that the number is some n, we want to prove that for each less number of vertices, the statement is correct, and then give a counterexample on the less number of vertices. Okay, so what can we prove for the Ramsey number? Okay, can you tell me what is? Well, first of all, let's calculate the R of 1 and R of 2. It should be not so hard. So just look by definition, and you can just write in chat your answers. I don't think that this is rather obvious, but I couldn't also just read the definition. Maybe just think about it. So what is R of 1 and R of 2? Maybe it's confusing because you don't understand what it means when the book has read one bit. If you want the one that we, it means that we have the one vertex where all edges are red. So if you want me, it means that we have one vertex with all the edges of which are red. But in fact, it will be true for every vertex. So if we have one vertex, then this vertex will be directly in. But just the definition. So what does it mean? We have one vertex, and so all edges between all vertices are red. We can come with that. Because we don't have another vertex, but all the edges between all verses here are so R of 1 and the set 1. Here R to n means that either we have, so if we have red edge, it means that we have to bleed two red bleed, yes, red bleed. If we have red edge, so either we have what is the answer here? 2n? 2, but you have n. So, for example, if you have r to 5, either you have 2 red to bleed or blue 5. So, either you have one red edge, or we need to have blue 5p. So complete graph of 5 vertices, there are all edges of blue. What's the possible minimal number you can achieve both of this? So I have this pro or this pro. I have if we have two vertices, then we can just draw this graph. This graph doesn't contain no distances. So if we have two vertices, then we can just take full graph all the way to color in blue. And so this graph doesn't contain any radiation or blue path field. So this counterexample, we can say that this number is greater than 4. But can we obtain that this is equal to 5? So is it true that every graph of 5 vertices will have either red edge or blue path field? Is it correct? So you can see in the picture that so we have five pictures here. And so in all these five pictures, either we have one red edge or all edges are blue. Okay. Yes. So if we look at the graph of five edges and color them into two colors, all the edges. So if we have one red edge, then of course we have subgraph the morphic to K2, which is red. Or all edges are blue, which means that we have our full graph blue, and so we have blue K subgraph. Okay, so I suppose that this now proves that this number is equal to n. So how to prove it? For n minus 1, we have counterexample. And the example will be containing the subgraph on k of n minus 1 vertices, but all edges are blue, or the second color. And so the graph doesn't contain any red edges or subgraph is isomorphic to Kn. But if we take n vertices, if we take Kn, so if we count that there are exactly two options, we have at least one red edge, and this means that we have red two deep. Or all edges are which means that we have blue and so for any coloring of the edges of property N, we have either red to bleed or blue at bleed. And so R of to N is N. Yes, here goes right here. R of N. Okay, so we have R of 1 and arbitrary number. Now, of course, I don't mention it, but of course, it is from the definition that R of ST is equal to R of TS, because we just change the color. And so we now calculate R of 1, R of 2, and R of 3. Okay, what are the possible questions? So the main question which was asked after the definition of this number. So if R of ST is 5. So the main question is, can we just take, so for arbitrary of T, can we take the large number and then in each color we have to have red, green, or blue technique. But even blue, we found this as some function of C. So maybe function of C is not appropriate right here. But maybe we just basically take number here, so just take R and S. And so we just try to look at what is what is the symbol to is it exponential or is it linear function of S. So we want to ask about what the growth of function of R of S.
Actually, we don't have any formula for R of ST, any beautiful formula. And we all have known is just like several Ramsey numbers. So if you want to know just actually the number of R of ST, so on today we know something like. So we know R of SK for, maybe I should check newest result, but I suppose that we have like K not greater than 9. I don't know if you have known the R of 39, but maybe. Yeah, I just need to check it. So just if you look at, so you know this, we know R of 4, 4, 4, 5, and I suppose 4, 6, and then we know maybe the R of 5, 5. This is so. If we ask for actual number of Ramsey numbers, so we just know about this. I'm not sure about R of 39. Maybe I would look at Wikipedia. And. So, because last time I checked, like a year ago, maybe there's something changes. But we just why it is so hard to find the actual Ramsey numbers? Because we need to if we need to provide a counterexample, or just if we need to prove the statement. For each two colorings. So can we calculate how many colorings of, so if we have graph on n vertices, how many two colorings do we have? Two colorings of edges. How many two colorings of edges do we have? Can you just give me the answer? Sorry, can you speak louder, please? 2? So 2 to the power n choose 2. Yes, because there is number of edges is n choose 2, and each of this edge is can be coloring 2 times. So for example, if we have R of 5, 5, I need to look at different... if I want to prove that R of 5, 5 is, I don't know, 40, for example, then I need to look at all possible colorings of graph of 2 to the power 40 choose 2, and 40 choose 2 is very, very big number, so 40 choose 2 is 40 times 39 over 2, so it is 2 to the power 780. And this is very big number. So nowadays computers can make like 2 to the power, I don't know, 30 operations, but not this big enough. And R of 5, 5 is, maybe I was a little bit optimistic. Yeah, we know the R39, the R39 is 36, and R310 is between 40 and 42. We know R45, but not R46, and we either don't know R45 here. Sorry, I was a little bit optimistic here. So, for example, R45 now is known that R55 is between 43 and 48. Yeah, no, maybe Wikipedia is wrong, so maybe we have newest result which has proved that we can find this on this one. But if you have like, so to prove that R45 is like 45, we need to do so much calculations that nowadays computer scanners achieve. And of course, there are just not. Yeah, so something we can prove, and this something cannot is using some better algorithm than just looking at all graphs and try to find which graphs are true. So which is not this number, we need to provide an algorithm. So the modern proofs, if you take an article of proving that, I don't know, that R5 is greater than 43, then I suppose that they'll be happy, like, look at this algorithm that was provided before to prove that R5 is more on 42 or less than 49, and then let's do some change of algorithm. Then there is just code on the algorithm that we will do, and then we'll prove using this newest algorithm that it is less than 49. So all this proofs, or all this estimate bounds, are proven using some tricky algorithm, and just using the operations that we can achieve. So can we just prove something better for these Ramsey numbers? Okay. Let's do the first step. So we want to, actually want to prove that R of ST is finite, but first of all, let's check, can we prove it something for, I don't know, not for all of these numbers, but some of them. So the next task is, can we just find the R of 3-4? Of course, we know that R of 3-3 is 6. And then, of course, R34 will be, I suppose, greater than 6. But I think it's easy to see that if we have 6 vertices, that we cannot color the two edges of them, such that we don't have, so we need to have red triangle or a blue graph isomorphic to K4. And I suppose that we can draw a picture, which is counter example for this one. So, for example, we just do we want to get, for example, this graph has no red triangles, and if we draw all the blue edges, then we can check that if it is not, it will not have K4 blue subgraph, because if we choose arbitrary vertices here, then two of them will have the red edge. So they will be neighbors, and so they will have one, at least one red edge. So I just prove that R of 3-4 is strictly greater than 6. So again, if you can draw an example for 7 or 8 or 9, you can just try and we need to do so prove two things. Yes, first of all, we need to find a counterexample, and then prove that this number is not bigger than some number. So we can I think first you can do it, just write some counter examples. We just maybe just wait for 4 minutes and we can discuss which counter example can you achieve, and then we will prove that if we take n plus one, then we will have this actual number of r of 3-4. Yeah, so if you have any pictures for 7 or 8 or 9, you can just draw it and draw it on the board or draw it in your paper and just photo it and send to me in Telegram, for example, and I will represent it on the board. Have counter example, so we can just try to achieve the actual number of r of 3-4. Yes, I can. If someone can draw a picture for 7 vertices, then go ahead and can show me. Just go to the board and draw it. Yes, do have, do someone have a picture for like 70 word set, for example? No. We can have the same idea on 70 words because if we draw like one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. We don't have red triangles. But if we choose any four vertices, any four blue vertices here, the two of them have one edge. They will be adjacent using the red coloring. And so we'll not have blue triangle here. So here is a counterexample for the 7 words. And for the, if you look at the 8, the same construction may be not true, because if we just take arbitrary 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 vertices, then we can have 4 vertices such that they are not neighbors. And the two possible situations is when we have the even or odd number. If you enumerate the vertices, then we have even vertices or odd vertices. Here, only two possible examples where we have no red edge between them. But now, so we just need to add two more red edges just to be sure that this graph, this for these two graphs, graph on vertices, will be not blue. But we don't want to make a new triangle, so we do like I don't know. So if you, for example, provide this edge, then we have a triangle. So we need to do this one. And for example, this one. And so we will have now, we don't have red triangles still, because this new edges doesn't add. So if we have this edge, so we just need this edge or this edge to be triangle. So we don't have red triangles. But if you look at the all blue possible for click, then so either we have two vertices which are neighboring into this 8 cycle, or we have odd or even vertices which don't have K4 because we restrict it using this as edges. So this is a counterexample for 8. Okay, can we just try to prove, starting to prove that R of 3, 4 is. So this proves that R of 3, 4 is greater than 8, because we have counterexample on 8. And we want to prove that R of 3, 4 is not bigger than 9. So I started the same idea that we discussed before. So we just take any vertex and look at all edges that are coming from it. And the idea is that if we have four red edges coming out of this vertex, then what can happen? If we have, so look, let's look at these four vertices here. Either we have one red edge on this vertex, or all edges are blue. So this is exactly the four, it is exactly the number of R of 2-4, as we proved before. And so we either have one red edge, or all edges are blue. And so if we have one red edge, then we'll have the red triangle. And the another possible situation is when we have all edges are blue. Is when we have k for subgraph which with all edges are blue. So if we have if at least one vertex of our graph have at least four red edges, then we can get the red triangle or the four click containing only blue edges. Okay, what about the restrictions of number of red edges? If vertex has six blue edges, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what can we say about these six vertices? This six vertices, the six is number of R of 3, 3, which means that of any coloring there exists either red triangle or blue triangle. And so we have two possible situations here. So if we have red triangle, then we have achieved the situation we have red triangle. But if it has blue triangle, then when we add our vertex, we will have here we have graph K4 using only blue edges. So what I said is that if we have, so if our edge, so if vertex has more than equal than four red edges, or at least six blue edges, then we have either K3 red subgraph, so red triangle, or K4 blue subgraph. But we have nine edges. So we have the degree of all our vertices as 8. And so what is the unique situation? What is the situation where this can be achieved? So what is the situation where we don't have at least four edges or at least six blue edges? Can someone save me? So what happens if we cannot achieve this? If we cannot, Is it always cold? So is it always true that the vertex has either at least four edges or at least six edges? Oh no. Oh no. Yeah, so suppose we have a graph on nine edges, yes? So we have nine vertices. So we have a graph of nine vertices. We already proved that R of 3-4 is greater than 9, less than 8. Let's prove that it's equal to 9. If you want to prove it's equal to 9, we want to suppose, so we can prove for any graph on 9 vertices, that either for each two columns, we have either three, either red triangle, or four graph isomorphic to blue graph isomorphic to K4. So I just already proved that if vertex has at least four edges, so we suppose we have a two coloring. We color all edges into two colors. If the red degree of the edge is greater than four or equal, then we have what we need. If it has at least six blue degrees, then also we prove what we need. So is it all possible situations? So is it true that if we color the graph on nine vertices, there will be vertex which have at least four red degrees or six blue degrees? Or we have or we have an example where it is not correct. So what is the degree of our vertex when we have graph K9? What can you please answer? What is the degree of every vertex in complete graph K9? Sorry? 8. Okay. Can we can we somehow, so the degree of it is sum of the red degree and blue degree. Can we have a situation where none of this is true? So we have less than four edges and less than six blue edges. If we have a degree equal to 8. Yeah, the unique situation is if it is not true. If it is not true, then the degree of our vertex is 8, and if it's red is not greater than 3, and blue is not greater than 5, then the unique possible situation is where R equal to 3 and blue equal to 5. So for each edge, so we have graph on nine vertices, where each of the vertex will have three red edges and five blue edges. So again, if it's not true, so if none of the vertices, this is correct, then this is true, then each of these vertex has red degree equal to 3 and blue degree equal to 5. Can we achieve this on the graph on 9 vertices? Can we draw a graph on 9 vertices? A graph on 9 vertices? For example, we can say that we draw only the red edges and we don't draw the blue edges. So can we have achieved a graph on 9 vertices where every degree of each vertex is 3? Can we draw such graph? Does this graph exist or not? If it exists, we can draw it and check that it is counterexample for our R34. Or if it not exist, then is the unique possible counterexample. So if it not exist, then we prove that R34 is equal to 9. So the main question is, can we obtain the graph on 9 vertices where every degree is equal to 3? Yeah, of course. So this degree is odd, and we need to have the number of odd degree vertices is even. use the head-shaking lemma because the number of edges will be 9 × 3/2, which is the number of edges which should be a natural number. So we can't achieve it. So we cannot draw this graph. If we can draw this graph, then this is always true, and so we prove that we have either K4 red subgraph or K3 red subgraph, so we have red triangle, or the full subgraph of blue of K4 with blue edges. Okay, so we prove that R(3,4) is equal to 9. But you see that it is not, so it may be not hard, but it's not very easy. It's not very easy to prove that R(3,4) is equal to 9. But the idea that we used here in this proof is can help us to prove the inequality in the arbitrary case. So let's state the theorem that R(st) is not greater than sum of R(s-1t) plus R(st-1). And so, for example, here we prove that, as a given example, so for example, we can check that R(3,3) is not greater than R(2,3) plus R(3,2). This is 3, this is 3, and this is 6, and we see that we have must be not, we cannot use Bethe inequality because here we have even number, so 6 is equal to 3 plus 3. But if the numbers in the right hand side are even, then we can make the better inequality if R(s-1t) and R(st-1) are even, then we can make better bound. We can wrote -1 here. And this is actually is the same trick as we discussed with R(3,4). And here we can write that R(3,4) is not greater than R(2,4) plus R(3,3). This is 4, this is 6. If they are all even, then we can use the strong inequality and prove that R(3,4) is not greater than 9. And if we prove this theorem, then we can prove that R(st) is finite using the induction hypothesis, because if we prove that this number is finite for the where the sum of these components is not greater than n, then we can prove that it is finite where the sum of the components is n. And so by induction, we can prove that from this, we can prove that R(st) is finite. And actually, you see that this is can remind you of some binomial identity using binomial coefficient. And from this, we can just we'll prove that R(st) is not greater than the number of combination of S(t-2)/S-1. And so we can have from this, if you know the some estimation of, so if we want, if we can construct the approximation of binomial coefficients, then we can construct the upper bound for R(st). Okay, so this is the plan for the second part of the lecture. I think we have now have a break, like 10 or 15 minutes, and then we will continue. So I will prove the theorem. We'll discuss some corollaries of this theorem. And then I don't know if we have much time, and we can just say some conclusions about arbitrary situation. Maybe we'll continue talking about terms and numbers in the beginning of the next lecture, and then we'll be going to our next topic.
Continue talk about proving the theorem. Basically, I actually told this to you twice, but in proof RC3 and proof RC4, so I just can repeat all the same ideas. So if you need to prove the theorem, we need to take n equal to sum of r s minus 1 t plus r of s t minus 1 and prove that for each two coloring of kn we have either red ks or blue kt. Okay, let's take arbitrary vertex and look of the edge coming out of this vertex. So fixed vertex V and use the same idea as we used for proving the previous statements. So if we have a big number of red edges, then if we have red edges enough, such that on this graph we have either S minus 1 red click or T blue click, then we can prove that we have what we need. If we have the big number of blue edges, such that we have here either red S click or T minus 1 blue click, then we have what we need. And so we just need to prove that either we have this one or this one situation. So we fix vertex V. What is the degree of V? The degree of V is n minus 1. N minus 1 is r minus 1 t plus r of s t minus 1 minus 1. So we have three possible situations. First possible situation that red degree. So let's denote by red degree the number of red edges that coming out of the vertex V. As the red degree is more or equal than r of s minus 1 t, the second option is the blue degree of V is more or equal than r s t minus 1. And what is the third option? The third option is that none of this is true. And this means that the red degree is less or equal than RS minus 1 T minus 1. The blue degree is none greater than R of S T minus 1 minus 1. And from this, we mean that the degree of V is the sum of this red degree and blue degree, and this will be not bigger than R of S minus 1 T plus R of S T minus 1 minus 2. But this contradiction with this one
So this can happen, and so the third case will be not happen. So we either have first case or second case.
Okay.
So let's look at these two cases separately. The first case is when the degree of red vertex is more or equal than SR of S minus 1T. What does that mean? It means that we have vertex and we have many, 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 many number of red edges such that the number of vertex at the end of these edges is at least R of S minus 1T. Let's just take number of vertices equal to R of S minus 1T. What does this mean? That this vertex, the number of this vertex is R of S minus 1T. This means that we have two possible options. So either we have, so if we consider our coloring of our graph restricted on these vertices, then we can say that we have either blue cyclic, or we have red S minus one click. So in the second case, we have blue cyclic, we obtain what we need, because we want to prove that for each coloring. So I just maybe not mentioned, but of course I just take the graph KN and then look at arbitrary coloring of the edges. So we want to prove that either we have red KC or blue KC at this point. This case is okay because we obtain the T vertices where every edge on this vertex is blue. But what if we have red S minus one click? We have vertex V, which is connected with all these vertices with red. So we add these vertices to this click and we obtain S click. So these vertices plus V will be red S click. And so we also be okay. This is the same technique as we used in the previous two proofs. We just take as much possible red as we need to obtain from this guy that we have red S click or blue T click. Okay, this is about the first case. Second case is similar. I just repeat all that I said before. So if we have enough blue edges here, so we have blue edges, many, many blue edges, and they all finished in at least R of S T minus one vertices. Then again, we have two options. Either we have red S click, and then we obtain what we need. We have S red S click, the click on S vertices where all the edges are red, or we have a T minus one blue T minus one click, and then we this plus vertex V will be a blue T click, and then we also be okay. And so we prove the main statement that if we take this number of vertices, R of S minus 1T plus R of S T minus 1, then we can obtain the graph for each two coloring of its graph will have either red KS or blue KT. Okay, so what about restrictions that I take? So what about second part of the theorem?
So if, so what if, maybe I know that this maybe not will be very useful, but I try to change our my proof if these two numbers are even. So the, if this number are even and this number are even, we want to prove the better restriction that we can take here minus one. Okay, so well, the same idea we're holding until here. So now the degree will be, will have minus one. And so the third case will be not a contradiction. Why? Because some, in some case we will have this degree will be, so the unique possible situation where this is not a contradiction is where we can achieve the equality here. So if it's not a contradiction, then we will have here not an equality, but equality. So this means that third case can be also possible if the red degree of the vertex is exactly R of S minus 1 T, and the degree of blue vertex is exactly R of S T minus 1 minus 1. This is a unique possible situation because here we have D of V not greater than this minus 2, this is equal to N minus 2, that then it will happen only if this is equal, and so this means that we have identity both of this case. But this must be true. So suppose we have so if for any vertex V, so if there exists a vertex V for which we can obtain one or two, then we can proceed to these guys and we'll have what we need. But if it's not true, then for every vertex V we will have these equalities. If no one and two happens for all vertices, then for all vertices we'll have this identity. And again, using the hand-shaking lemma, we can prove that it is not, is this cannot be true, because this number is odd. So we have odd. So degree of the red edges will be odd for every vertex in our graph, which can be correct because the number of we have odd number of vertices totally, and each vertex has odd degree, and this cannot be happening. Maybe I should write it here. Hence, we have a graph G with odd number of vertices, and the degree of each vertex is odd, and this contradicts the handshaking lemma. So it means that number of red edges is equal to the number of vertices times the degree of RV over 2, but it is not a natural number. So this proves the second part of the theorem, that we can lower this upper bound by 1 if there all these numbers are even. Okay, what about now corollaries of this theorem? First of it, of course, we prove that R of ST is finite. So we actually can prove that R of ST is not greater than S plus T minus 2 by S minus 1. Let's prove this one. So we prove it by induction. Let's check that this is hold for R. So if I take R of 1 n, then it is 1, and here we'll have 1 plus n minus 2 over 0, which is also 1. So this is false. And if we take R of 2 n, which is n, here we'll have n plus 2 minus 2 over 2 minus 1, which is n choose 1, which is n. So we have equality here. So I just check the base of induction, and then by induction hypothesis, we can draw that R of ST is not greater than R of S minus 1T plus R of ST minus 1, and this is not greater than S minus 1 plus T minus 2 over S minus 2 plus S plus T minus 1 minus 2 over S minus 1. So this is S plus T minus 3 over S minus 2 plus S plus T minus 3 choose S minus 1. And we know this identity, that this sum is S plus T minus 2 over choose S minus 1. So we know that if we have two binomial coefficients, which is, so the base is the same, but the lower numbers differ by 1, then we can achieve the binomial coefficients with n plus 1. So upper number is bigger on the 1. Okay. So now prove that R of ST is not greater than this binomial coefficients, and of course R of ST is finite from this. So if you want to actual function, that we know that R of SS is not greater than 2S minus 2 over S minus 1. So we can just, if you want to estimate bound, we need to just to somehow make an approximation of 2N choose N. And this is the biggest number, but easily restriction will make that it is not greater than 2 to the 2 power n, and so we can say that this is not greater than 4 to the power s. And actually it can be proven using some probability technique that R of SS is from the, if S is big enough, we can prove that it is greater than 2 to the power S with some, maybe I would just write something like this. You do know the notations like O small? Yeah. So just something like 2 to the power s. So maybe with some constant, but I don't. So we just maybe there may be some constant, but I just don't remember the constant. So the R of SS has exponential growth, but we have bigger gap here because we just, so we have 4 here and 2 here, and so it's big enough, but I don't know, is there a better, so maybe there are a little better estimates into the base here, but we don't have any better bounds for the R of SS. Okay. So we'll have like, I know, at least 10 more minutes. Actually, so there are more different topics, so there are just I just maybe have a rough estimation about other things that we can do here. So what about some generalizations? Generalization. So you can ask yourself a different number of questions. So first of all, can we change? So we have two restrictions here. We suppose that we want to find the complete graph colored by the same color, and so we have two possible generalizations. First of all, we can assume that we look at the number of R of G H, where G is and H is arbitrary graphs, and we want to find before that, we assume that we want to find, so we've colored the complete graph and want to find the subgraphs isomorphic to KS or KL, KT. But now we can just try to find the subgraphs isomorphic to G and H. So we can try to find not full graph colored in one color, but just some, you know, cycle, tree, maybe triangle and something, just square, for example. And so this is just the minimal n such that for each coloring of kn there exists either red subgraph isomorphic to J or blue subgraph isomorphic to H. And of course this is number is finite because the Ramsey number is finite, and so if we can have full subgraphs, then of course in this we'll have G and H, but G and H, but maybe with some restrictions of the graph we can have better estimates, and so maybe it will be linear or something. So there are plenty of different things that you can do with these guys. Another generalization is just to add more colors. So we just talk about two colors, but we have no restriction. We can just look at some S colors. Suppose we have S colors, and we want to find the minimal number of N such that for each S coloring of the full of the complete graph Kn, we have either K1 click of first color, K2 click on the second color, or Ks click on the last color. Minimal n such that for each coloring of Kn into S colors, we have either K1 click of first color, K2 click of second color, and so on, KS click of last color. So I already said that R of GH is finite, and so again, the main question is, can we prove that this is finite? And yes, we can. Yes, we can. Let me do the proposition. We just can say that. So it's something called, so it's called like multicolored Ramsey number,
suppose.
Multicolored Ramsey number.
We can just, so what's the main idea? We will prove by induction by number of S, and we want to restrict this to the less number of colors. If we prove so for two colors, then we can prove it for arbitrary number of colors. And so we just, I just wrote the estimation, and then we'll check that this is correct. I suppose that we can just take R of, for example, R of K1, K2, K3, etc., Ks. Maybe I will, so we'll look at the proof. Well, we maybe, I think it's enough, but maybe we just can change a little bit of this number so this to be correct. So what happens here? We just take the this number of vertices. So let's take R equal to R of K1, K2. And what can we say? So if we prove by induction, so it is correct. So this statement that this number is finite is so this will happen for S more or less than 3. And so by induction we prove that this number is finite. R of L1, L2, etc., Ls minus 1 is finite. So this number is finite. And if we take, so let's take arbitrary vertex. And so suppose arbitrary coloring on S minus 1 coloring of this graph. And so we have either so what I need to do? I want to just look at the number of vertices of the each of the color. So if let me think. Yeah, so maybe I don't need to do this. Yeah, sorry. So if you take, yeah. So what does it mean that we have the n this big enough? It means that by definition, if we consider the coloring of so is it finite? And so what does it mean? Is it means that if we have S minus 1 coloring of this graph? Then we have either R of K1, K2 vertices where all the edges are of color 1. K3 vertices of color 2, K4 vertices of color 3, and so on. Ks vertices of color S minus 1. So for each coloring, we have either one of these options. Okay, let's look at our graph. Color all the edges into S colors, and then just match the so make the first and second colors the same. So we now have S minus one colors. We look at this coloring of S minus one coloring of this graph, and we have one of these options. But our colors will be shifted, so this color became 3. So this is the initial third color, this is initial fourth color, this is initial S color, and this will be 1 and 2 color together. So if we have one of these options, then we achieve what we need. We achieve either K3 subgraph on K3 versus roll edges of the color 3, K4 versus of the color of edges 4, and so on. But now we have one additional option where we have R of K1, K2 vertices where all edges are colored of one of color 1 and 2. But R of K1, K2 is the Ramsey number, which means that if we have this number of vertices and if they have color in the two colors, so we have now, again, here we have two options. Either we have K1 vertices, which is color of the color 1, or K2 vertices, which is colored by the color of K2. And so we again achieved what we need. So either we have this option or this option. So together, we have achieved one of these bigger options. So we can prove that, again, multicolor of some Ramsey number is finite, but of course this is not a very, so we don't have like beautiful estimation like we have into two colors, because we have here, so we have function of function. This means that if we try to bound it the Ramsey number which is colored in S colors, we need to just construct like the tower of powers of 2s, and so it's a very, very big number. But of course it is better to know that this is also finite. So actually we can talk about, so if you want to talk about some beautiful implications of this theory, then I don't think so I have much time to talk about this, but actually we have some beautiful geometric applications. So like I just maybe take 5 more minutes to take a, you know, a small survey about this, and maybe you will just think about this problem. So suppose we have arbitrary endpoints on the plane. The question is, so suppose we fixed, suppose we have fixed the number, I know, the number k, and we want to ask if there are always k points of this n, which form the convex k polygon. It doesn't need to be regular, just like, so for example, if k equal to 5, I just take like I don't know, these are 5 vertices with will have k convex polygon. So if there exists k convex of course if n is low enough, then we can't achieve, so for example if we have k minus 1 points, we can't achieve the convex polygon, and if you have n equal to k points, these points cannot form, they will not form convex polygon. But now let's take a bigger n. Is it true that for each k n we can find the number n of k such that if we take arbitrary endpoints on the plane,
that we can always achieve the convex k-polygon. So somehow there in this big number of points, we can always achieve the convex k-polygon. And it is interesting that we can use, actually, this is similar to some so this is the kind of application. So this is the application of Ramsey theory. So we can use the Ramsey theory here to prove something with some geometric conjecture using the Ramsey theory. And I will just try to say the main idea, and then this is, will be tend us to some tricky Ramsey number, but I will not prove that it's fine, and maybe you will, some of you will be proving this, that this is Ramsey number is fine. So so for example, if you have like k equal to 3, then it is trivial because we have for each 3 points that we need to assume that our points are arbitrary enough. So for example, not every there are no 3 points that line on the one line, belonging to the one line, because if we have all points on the one line, of course we don't have the n convex polygon. So we have the arbitrary points. I don't know how to say it's not line. So three not each three not belonging to one line. So for example, k equals 3, we have n of k, we can take 3 points, and then each of those 3 points will form the convex triangle. But for k equal 4, we have bad example. So if we take like these 4 points, then they're not forming the convex polygon, and so we need to add one more point. But if we take 5 points, then it will be okay. If we take 5 points, fifth point, so if we take n of 4 is equal to 5, so if we take 5 points, then at least 4 of them will be making the convex polygon. And we just make proof. So we just take the boundary points. So we just look at the boundary points, and they form either triangle or, so we have either triangle or some co-polygon or some pentagon. So for example, this is so good. We will have the convex polygon of the neat number of vertices. But what's the main case is the triangle, and they will have 2 points into this triangle, and so we just need to draw a line between these points. And so if they cross any two sides of this triangle, then we can form a the since this picture, so this will be convex, and so we'll have here somewhere you have convex for polygon here. But what happened in arbitrary case? And so the main, so we need to I think I'll spend like 4 minutes more. So there is a statement about convexity. So if we have n points such that each four of them forms convex. So if you have n points such that each of four of them forms convex for polygon, then this will be convex. Then n polygon is convex. So if you have find n points such that each four of them forms a convex polygon, it means that whole polygon is convex. And I think that is so. It's just geometrical. You just think about it. So there will be no problems with convexity. We have each four of them will form convex polygon. So we have similar to the Ramsey theory. So we have n points, and if we can find n points such that each four of them, which have this convexity, then we'll have the n polygon is convex. But what about, so we have some property, convexity of four points. But if we have, what if we not have this convexity? But also we know for each five points, we have four points which forms convex polygon. So now just it's okay. So now we will take about some different generation of Ramsey number. This is Ramsey number on hypergraph, because here what I want to do something like this. I want to color all possible four. So I have n vertices, and I want to color not the edges, but all subsets of the four elements. So I just have n points, and I just color all possible subsets of four points. So this is just like when we talk about hypergraphs, we're just talking that edges can contain more than two vertices. It can contain three vertices, four vertices, and so on. And now I look at coloring. So I just look at all possible vertices of so all subsets of length four, and I color all subsets of length four. And so I take each of these four vertices, I will take blue if it is convex, and red if the form it's not convex for polygon of these four points. And now I will have the following. So if I take this generalization of Ramsey number of hypergraphs, where I have I wrote here R4, meaning that I look at subsets of four elements. So I took something like R4 of n and 5. So what is this number? This number means that this is so big n that either I will have, maybe I should wrote key here. So this is big number n such that if I color all four subsets of this set, then either I will have k elements where all four subsets are colored in the first color, or I will have five elements which where all four elements are colored in the different color. And if I prove that this is finite, then I can use this to this problem, because if I take this number of points on the plane, Either I will have k points where each four of them forms convex for polygon, which means that this polygon is convex. So this means that I'm now k and then drag to k. Or I will have five points where each of them, each four of them, not forming the convex polygon, but this is not true because for each five points we have at least one point which is convex. So this cannot happen. And so I will state that this is true, and so I will find the number of arbitrary points on the plane such that the k of them is formed convex k polygon. Yes, so this is a nice geometric application of the Ramsey's theory. We have lesser number of minutes to the test, but actually I will have only two tasks on this test, so it's, I think it's not a problem.